Hey everyone, Clay's here with Dungeons and Javas, helping you stay up to level up. I've been grinding hard on my standard deck here, with Doom Foretold being the main card in it, and everything else is kind of built around it. And I've earned some hard-earned coins, so figured I would go ahead and try and jump into another draft and get better at drafting. Lord knows I need it, so figure we'll go with the Ravnica Allegiance draft just because it's not going to be around forever, so should take advantage of it while I can. I have drafted this a little bit offline. Been doing pretty well, been at least earning my gems back, which is always a good thing. And surprisingly, I've been doing well going three colors, but that's mainly because there are so many gates and some cards that fetch up gates that allow you to play three colors pretty easily. So there's a lot of mana fixing in this set. But ultimately, it's going to depend on what cards fall for us. So hopefully, we'll get some good cards and put together a good deck and have a couple of good games. By the way, if you haven't already joined our Discord server, check us out at Discord. Just server name is Dungeons and Javas. And if you post screenshots of your Friday Night Magic gameplay, I will send you some codes for some free goodies. So you can get some sleeves, some alternate cards, some packs. Stuff like that. So far, it's been going pretty well, and I think it's going to continue to do well. Let's see what we got here. So, there is a pretty strong theme in this set with white black. It's the afterlife, and it does give you some 1/1 flying spirits, which is very potent, especially if you can just get a bunch of creatures out, big threats, make them deal with those, and then still make them have to deal with your afterlife creatures. So, Tithe Taker, pretty decent two drop here. I do like going with a Vindictive Vampire if you're going with the afterlife theme, and I'm not really seeing anything else that really stands out. I mean, there is a Scorch Mark, which is good removal, but I think I am going to go ahead and see where the afterlife mechanic takes me here. So it is white black, and seeing a Mortify drop right here is very decent indeed. And not seeing anything that necessarily stands out beyond that. Now, like I said, it's pretty easy to go three colors in this set, so I'm not ruling that out. But right now, I'm going to take what's best in my colors. So, Priest of Forgotten Gods. It's pretty good if you can make your opponent sack a creature, plus if you have other cards that pay you off for sacrificing your creatures, like Afterlife. I do like the Colossus side of Collision Colossus. That's really strong. Plus 4, plus 2, and Trample. Of course, here's a little bit of mana fixing. If I wanted to consider that. But as of right now, sticking with the afterlife theme, I'm going to go with the priest. And it looks like some pretty good cards are falling here. The Ministrant of Obligation spits out two flyers. Final payment's really good too. It is at common though, so I'm going to hope a few more of those come around. And Blade Jugular. Pretty good juggler, pretty good. Does give you card draw when it comes in. But sticking with the theme here, Afterlife, we're going to take that. All right, so it's a 3/3 for 3. It's not too terrible. I do like the flash aspect of that. And it would allow me to pump up some of my flyers a little bit. I am kind of taking a look at this Vigilance Afterlife 2/1. And because I took the Priest of Forgotten Gods, I think I've got to take an Afterlife card every time I have the opportunity. So I'm going to go ahead and select that one here. Still entertaining the possibility of going a third color. Maybe red black, since it does appear that a lot of those cards are getting passed to me and get to the points really good. So not necessarily an afterlife card, but it does kind of have a little drain life aspect to it. Of course, the 3/1 lifelink vampire isn't too terrible either. Going white blue is a possibility as well, splashing some blue in here for some card draw. I don't ever hate that. And this is a 5-drop, 3/3 flyer. It's decision time. Either I go with this or I splash a second color or a third color here. If I did, I'd probably try and roll with this. A little too early to think to go into my third color just yet, so I am tempted by blue because I just love blue. And of course, now I'm not really getting much of anything. This is quite interesting with all my 1/1s that I'll have. So I think I'm going to try and splash some red here. So my choices here, I think, are just to go ahead and pick a gate or a life-linking creature. And I could choose something that's a little bit more aggro. I think I'm pretty strong on my creatures so far, and I'm going to be picking a lot of creatures with afterlife, so I'm just going to take the gate here. Maybe we'll get a card later on that does pay off for gates. So the red-black mechanic in this set is spectacle. I do like the gate being presented here. Interesting that Scorch Mark is being passed. I'm going to go ahead and take the Scorch Mark. Hopefully, I'll have an opportunity for another Rakdos Guild Gate here at some point. Although, this is the second Scorch Mark I've seen. Don't think that's getting played very much. Nothing really in my colors here. Isn't too terrible. I probably won't end up running it, but. And let's see. Nothing stands out for me here, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and take the gateway to help me splash into my third color. And hey, there's a Rakdos Guild Gate. That's very interesting too, with all of my 1/1s though. I think I'm going to consider taking this guy to pump up my army of 1/1s. There is a Menace. Very good card. Pumpable in my colors. Little evasion. Lifelinker got passed late. And a creature I probably won't end up running because he's too high converted mana cost. Alright, Gutter Bones. Really good for my sac outlets here. There's another Afterlife 2 guy, but he is 6 mana. Afterlife 2, yeah. I do like. I've done really well drafting the Simic colors in this set when you have cards like Sharktooth Crab that can just keep cards tapped down and things like Growth Spiral. I'm going to go ahead and take Gutter Bones here. Seems like the clear-cut best choice. Sharktooth Crab's back to back. All right. Nothing much in my colors here. Little bit of hand disruption I'm not real big on. Six mana cost removal. That's pretty tough. I am not liking anything, any of my options here. I guess we'll go ahead and go Death Touch and draw a card. At least it replaces itself. Wow, Simic, super strong in this. Okay. I am kind of light on removal. I wouldn't mind a couple more red burn. Do have white, so we could do that here. Think I'm going to go with the Afterlife. There's a gate payoff if I wanted to try try and go that route. Let's see what my other options are here. Person to my left may be drafting my colors here. So I've got two gates at this point. Probably I'm going to take some more. Not really seeing anything else. I mean, the 1-3 flyer is okay here. If I get enough gates, I'll consider running him. If not, well, I guess we'll regret not picking the 1-3 Pegasus. Been working for several hours on a Kaldheim video that I'll be posting here probably in the next couple of days. It's gonna have an overview of basically the whole set. All right, Syndicate Messenger, pretty decent. Also got a Guild Gate presented there. I'm not really caring about mill at this point. Pretty good for a instant speed, but being that the opponent chooses and I don't really have any big creatures, I'm just going to go ahead and go with the Afterlife here. All right, and as I said, I need to go with some removal, so I'm going to probably pick Final Payment here. Especially that allows me to activate the Afterlife on my creatures if I don't get a sac outlet like the priest. But as I was saying, the Kaldheim video should be posted in the next couple of days, so hoping to do a really good overview and touch on all of the mechanics, all of the different features of the set, some of the theme, but not go too deep. So check it out. Let me know what you think. All right, well, this pack right here is not very good at all. Possibly good for Burn Bright since it does pump my entire board. If I can get a bunch of flyers out, that could be a game winner for me. All right, and then we've got a really good sac outlet here in my colors. Nothing else really standing out. And we're back to pack one. The Sharktooth Crab made it all the way back. That's crazy. Wow. All right, well, I guess we'll take the Locket for a little bit of acceleration and late game card draw. Might not even run it. I can't believe nobody's drafting Adapt. Hey, there's a Guild Gate. Passioned Orator, not too bad this late in the game. All right, come on, pack three. Hook me up. That's not hooking me up. Ooh, although not at the last breath. It's good if you can get to 7 mana. Oh my. Well, it's got Afterlife 3. It's a 4/4. I don't think I'm gonna get the 7 mana very often, so I'm gonna take the 5-cost guy here with Afterlife 2, likely. I mean, I could take a Guild Gate, but not this early. Make sure there's no more removal, which it doesn't appear to be. So, going with the Racketeers. Pretty creature heavy so far. Wouldn't mind getting another Final Payment. There's some extra removal. Oh, there is an exile creature that could be pretty good. just going to stick with the Grotesque Demise here. Not seeing anything else. I could probably get away with just going with straight white-black. Hey, there's another final payment. Ask and ye shall receive. It's an interesting card. If I'm running red, if I'm mainly running red, I'll definitely take that. Cool thing about it is it doesn't require you to tap it, so you could cast it and sack it in the same turn. Although it is just power 3 or less, so it's usually not a game changer. Skewer the Critic's pretty good here. I'm going to go ahead and go with Final Payment. That's interesting, but because I'm just splashing red, I don't think I'm going to go with that. So I think because you can cast this for the spectacle, it is a little bit of card draw. I'm not really seeing anything else too appealing. I'm going to go ahead and go with the Juggler. It's another Afterlife guy. Seems pretty good. I do like combat tricks like this, but it has to be in the right deck, coming to play abilities and things like that. There's another Gate Colossus. Instant speed removal. That's kind of removal too, instant speed. A little bit of card draw with light at the stage. It's interesting. I think I'm going to go ahead and take the removal here. And this is a very interesting card for this deck. As is Footlight Fiend. I think I'm going to take the Bankrupt in Blood. So I know it requires sacrificing two creatures, but I think we could pull it off in this deck. Another Locket. Yeah, there's the 7 cost guy again. Gonna stick with the gate here. Not gonna draft or not gonna play that. Take another gate where we can get it. I haven't seen too much pure aggro out of this set. I'm sure it's there, but usually you have time to deal with lands that come into play tapped. Alright, how many gates am I rocking? 2, 3, 4, 5. Guess we'll take another gate. Probably won't run it, but yeah, lifelink could be good. Death Touch, and rounding it out with card of my colors. Alright, so I'm going to probably pause the video here, throw together my deck, see what that phone call was, and get back into the gameplay here soon. Alright, I'm back, and we've got the deck built. I pulled out most of the stuff that wasn't Afterlife. I did leave red in there, and probably could have cut it, but I think it's going to be pretty easy to splash that as a third color. And I believe that the cards that allows me to splash just offer me a little bit better deck, so we'll see how it plays out here. My first match. Ezekiel 25-17. Well, got some removal early on. Of course, we don't have red to play that yet, but it'll come. So I don't really see any turn 2 plays other than rocking the final payment here, so I think I'll drop a Gutterbones turn one rather than the Guildgate tapped, since that does come into play tapped. Do like this arena or whatever you call it with all of the Ravnica Guild symbols in it. There's me right there, primarily Orzhov. So I got a little bit of Rakdos and a tiny bit of Boros. Where's Boros? There it is. Hell, I might win this one by default. Okay, there we go. Gutterbones. All right, well, we'll swing in for two. There's pretty good removal for Gutterbones. Ain't coming back from that. So, nothing to do for turn three. Set up for the messenger for turn four. Hacrobat. I played the heck out of him when he was in standard. Let's see. Pumps for five. Or, excuse me, pumps to four power. And I could get rid of him now for five life. I think I'm going to go ahead and do that. I can just come back here with the bird. He's got his own gutter bones. All right. Let's go ahead and do a tithe taker here. Wish we had some red. But if wishes were horses, we'd all be eating steak, as Jane used to say. R.I.P. Firefly. Although, there is rumor that it's going to be coming back around. That was really good. All right. Well, I can't block it and kill it, so I suppose we'll just say no blocks here. Could have got rid of Gutterbones, but he would have came back. Come on, red mana. Should have been more specific. Although we can cast the big Colossus now, so that's good. Let's swing in with the bird. Does he have burn? Must have some sort of burn. He wouldn't be swinging with him. Oh, he's got Death Touch, that's why. So I think we'll go ahead and go like this. Take the potentially five. When that guy gets pumped to six, excuse me, when that guy gets pumped up. Guess I could have blocked him. But we've got removal now. So one of these guys do I want to destroy? He's not gonna. Well, he might sack that. That is an instant. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Let's see if we can get creative here. Hold the. He can't be blocked. So we could kill the Hacrobat. Take four. That's going to be interesting. All right. Well, maybe we'll hold this guy back and swing in for this. I didn't think he would block there. Sacrifice gutter bones here is what I want to see. Beautiful. Deal the two damage to me. As long as he doesn't have burn, we're golden. into the face, that is. Okay, I'm gonna lose two life there. Interesting, but that's okay. Oh, don't be so sure, sir. Don't be so sure. Don't think we need a guild gate. Well, I would have definitely have liked to have had pay. Okay. Well, he's got to block the Gate Colossus or it's game. So let's send in the team here. Sure, why not? He might have something to bring this guy back and drain me for one. If so, then it's a good game. Whew, outlasted that one. That was close. But what does it say? Your life source is a resource. Winning with one life is as good as winning with 20 life. Wise words in those tool tips. I probably should have went and gave you a peek at the deck here, since I am going to be cutting that part out of the video. But I can go ahead and show it here at the end. Look at how much bigger Garrick's arms is than than my avatar. It looks like his arms are as big as my avatar's body. This is a really good opening hand. Shocker that my opponent gets to go first. Well, I think we're just going to go ahead and get rid of the hybrid before you can adapt. That guy gets really big, really quick. Wow. Oh, well, he's Riot, so we don't get to get rid of him after all. That's a bummer. Let's see here. Got our bones in tapped. Oh, can't do that. Could set up a blocker. So I think what we'll go ahead and do is play this, drop the gutter bones in tapped, go ahead and play the cavalcade, take four. Yeah, remember when I said that there's not a lot of aggro in the set? It's Gruul. Gruul's got the riot mechanic, and they can come in with counters or haste. I really wish you would have gave him haste. What you waiting for, buddy? Okie doke. That's the guy that pumps everything. Well, does have trample. We'll go ahead and exile this guy, swing in for two, and take four back. All right. That was not a very good draw. Attacks. can dissuade him from attacking here. That guy's pumpable. Very interesting. That seems pretty good. Oh, let me see. Even if I pump my team, that really doesn't help me. We will at least have some blockers and some options here, so I think just got to do this for now. Burn Bright, that doesn't help us. Well, that was a pretty shitty draw. This is going to be nuts when he plays a creature. Here we go. What's the Mirror Match going to do? Mirror March. I'm excited to see how it goes. Oh, he's got to be disappointed there. All I can really swing in for here is the haste, is the rider, or the haster. Really? For sure block your guy. For a non-token creature. Oh, that's just the end of turn trigger. I was trying to figure out what was going on there. Well, it does let me kill that guy. Take four coming back. Guess that's what we got to do. Hopefully he draws a land. You know, I think we might need the Vigilance and Lifelink, so... And I don't think I can play this. Sacrifice unless you pay one. Whammy on the creature. Ah, shit. Ooh, that's just... I meant to say sorry there. So unfortunately, we cannot pay for the Gate Colossus yet. And we've got no choice but to block the 4-4, let the 3 through. Oh, he's got Trample, so that's game anyway. Well, we gave it a shot there, almost stabilized. If only he had made that a 3-3 with haste, that game would have been a lot different. Oh well, didn't really draw that well. Let's see what game 3 is going to hold in store for us. Hey, it's a miracle, I go first. What's not a miracle is how shitty of a first draw that is. I mean, if I get white, it'll turn around quickly. Rakdos Trumpeter. All right, well, we could waste a Burn Bright here. Oh, greetings. How are you, sir? Good old Ugin. I did take both the Lockets out of this deck. So I didn't really have many high mana cost cards. Oh my god. maybe that was a bad move. That's a big guy. All right, well, might as well use it. Getting ready to have my hand fill up. This is very frustrating. I'm about to take. Well, I guess I can leave him back for a blocker. And I normally run fewer than 17 lands, but this time I actually am running 17, so. It's even more frustrating to get mana screwed like this. Good game. Here it comes now. Right, the last time I got mana fucked, I went in and changed a bunch of mana around. I'm not going to do that this time, but I am going to show you the deck. So that you can at least see what I chose. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and take the Racketeers out, grab a Locket, and let's see here. Burnbright really isn't running as well as I thought it would, so we'll grab another Locket and see how that works out for us. Alright, a little bit better opening hand here. I guess maybe it could be argued that that last one was my fault for keeping that opening hand. Alright, we'll go ahead and pop that guy. It's Locket time. I do like that spell. I'm a big Azorius fan. Right, what kind of damage can you do for 5 mana? That kind of damage. Question is, let's go ahead and do this. We will sacrifice a creature or enchantment. Oh, no, I don't want to target it. Sacrifice that. Think that's a better move there than spending the Mortify. Guess we'll have to wait and see. Nothing really else here to do, so we'll go ahead and pop that and send into 2/2, knock him back down to starting life. Couple of removal spells here, feeling pretty good about that. Think he's got some sort of burn, probably. He's debating what to kill. All right. That'll be okay, because then we can sacrifice that. Let's draw cards. And I think we're going to go ahead and do that now. Tithe Taker and that guy. Get the afterlife there. No more value for him. That's a little bit better draw than last time. And we can pay the one from this. Whenever a creature control attacks alone, it gets pumped up. All right. Well. Swing in some flyers. Pretty decent. This guy's got a lot of mana. Hey, we've got Mortify. That's pretty funny. I mean, do I care? Got two other creature removal spells. Can he really need that much mo mana? Normally in EDH, that's a obvious get rid of. Think I'm gonna hold back. It's only got three cards in hand. Maybe it'll end up being a mistake that haunts me. Who knows? We'll see. Actually, I could just pay for it right now. Let me see. That'll leave me. Yeah, that's fine. Drop in my guild gate. Swing in with the team. Can't attack or block. All right. Probably could have just got rid of that with Mortify and swung it anyway. It's in the turn here. Got a couple of options. Riot and Trample. That seems pretty good. Just go ahead and tuck that plains there. Sure you can. Well, don't have anything else to do for the mana. Should we destroy that and swing in for two? Nah. So I think we'll be able to use that guy as a sacrifice outlet to final payment. Get rid of some big creature of his. Like the guy with reach. Then we'll get my 1/1. Pass. Sacrifice a creature. Target a creature. Sacrifice that guy. All right, well, let's go ahead and just make sure that that guy goes away. Things are looking pretty good so far. Go ahead and pay for that. That's kind of how this deck's supposed to run. Go ahead and just get rid of them, all the triggers on the stack. I know I could have just done that on my main phase, but you know what? I'll give you a. No, I All right, much better with mana. This game is a lot more enjoyable. Well, that's a pretty big difference between two wins and three wins. 250 gems or 1,000. So let's pull off this next win. Overall, I'm pretty happy with my draft, I think. Believe that I can't think of any choices that I would go back on right now. Nothing standing out to me. Although it sure would have been nice to be in Simic with all those Simic cards that were passed around pack two. Well, no red mana, but at least we'd have no red cards either. First time we're looking at the priest. Couple of oligarchs here. I kind of like this start. So I think what we'll do first off is drop one of those fellas. Then we'll drop the priest turn two when he has summoning sickness. Yep, still what I gotta do. Ooh, well, so much for that. Main boarded counter spells in a draft deck. See how that works out for him. Wow, got the oligarch train rolling. Well, that's pretty good. Go ahead and we'll just pay the 5 life here. And this is about as quick as a win as you could possibly have with these colors. Oh, is this guy going to be a jerk and just let his time run out? And that's game. In retrospect, maybe I didn't need to splash red. I've got one removal card. Was probably a deck building mistake on my part now that I think about it, just looking at the way that that just ran. I mean, was it worth it to splash for get to the point? Two removal spells. We could be running better cards here. I mean, that's kind of like a removal spell. But we're already down this road. I want to see how it plays out as I drafted it, or as I built it, so I think the past few drafts that I've had that have been offline that I've went three colors and I've been really successful almost made me think I needed to go three colors here. And I think my draft was solid enough to not have to splash that red after all. Especially since the red mana that I splashed ended up making me not have any white mana for that one match that I just got screwed on. So maybe that's a lesson learned from this video. An opponent goes first. Shocker. What is that? Four out of my five matches? He hurt me. Acrobat, there he is again. One of my favorite cards. Debating whether to go ahead and just kill Acrobat now with the final payment. I think I'm going to. So now we'll drop a Pontiff. Gate. Does suck that he can just basically be a two power creature with his death trigger. So I probably won't block here. Take the vicious one. Okay. Well, we can pay three this way and then drop the oligarch. Still exile this guy too, if we need to. Alright, so it's his turn. If I block, his is going to go on the stack. Mine's going to go on the stack. My card will come off. Create the 1/1, then he'll be able to deal 1 damage to it. Alright, so we can't kill that thing, because then it can kill this. So, well, we could exile it. We'll go ahead and destroy that. And since I know I'm not going to block, go ahead and start swinging in for some pain of my own. Always got vigilance. Anyway, forgot about that. No blocks, sir. A lifelinker. That's a pretty good top deck. So is this leaves or dies? Alright, good. We'll go ahead and exile your lifelinker too. Hopefully he's out of gas. Or he'll just drop an amazing creature. Well, that's pretty good. We'll do Gutter Bones. We'll do Final Payment. Sacrifice a creature. Target him. Sacrifice Gutter Bones. Attack with the Oligarch. Then bring back Gutter Bones. Not too shabby. Well, this guy's just got gas galore here. Wow, that was a pretty shitty draw. See, if I attack with this guy, he'll kill it. I'll get a 1/1. He'll attack back with Rebel Recluse. Yeah, it's not worth it yet. Because then Gutter Bones will come into play tapped, and he'd be able to swing through next turn with a because that's pretty much the same scenario that's playing out here. All right, becomes blocked. Awesome. Can you maybe draw some mana here? Instead of just constant gas, just every single card. Unbelievable. I've drawn 8 lands. 9 lands now. Unbelievable. And that's game. That was a hell of a draw on his part. And a hell of a shitty draw on my part. But at least I got the 1,000 gems out of the deal, so not bad for a 10,000 coin spend. And like I said, probably would have been better off going red mana, or without the red mana. But we should be at least able to get a wild card out of this deal. Oh, Kaya. Good to see you. A little precursor of who's coming up in Kaldheim. And I have no idea what this little treasure chest is. Alright, well, let's undo that. That's pretty cool. Never seen that before. Okay, well, hope you guys learned a little something from watching me draft and play. Maybe what to do, maybe what not to do, but at least you took something away from this video, hopefully. So, once again, this is Clay with Dunses and Javas. Our address for our store is 4420 Austin Bluffs Parkway in Colorado Springs. We've got Facebook. We've got a website, www.dunsesandjavas.com. And once again, our Discord channel is Dunses and Javas. Thanks again, and we'll catch you next time.